My question is for Dan Tehan. Dan, as a Catholic, can you see that Israel Folau quoting the Bible on social media in relation to the various types of sin, and given that he fully believes what the Bible teaches, is actually attempting to help people, to help them repent so as to be saved and therefore avoid hell? So that what he was doing cannot be so much classified as hate speech, but rather the opposite, and is in fact a brave act of love for those he is trying to help come to God.
Well, I think what the Israel Folau case shows us is that we need a Religious Discrimination Act in Australia, because what isn't clear at the moment is how we define the boundaries about what is, what we should be free to say and what we shouldn't, especially when it comes to our religious faith. We have it for sexual discrimination, we have it when it comes to disability, we have it when it comes to age, but we don't have anything which defines the boundaries in Australia properly when it comes to religious discrimination. And I think that's the key takeout and key lesson from the Israel Folau case, and it's why the government took to this election a policy where we wanted to see a Religious Discrimination Act put in place. And my hope is that we'll be able to see that done through this term of Parliament.
So, Dan, the obvious question, if the kind of Religious Discrimination Act that you wanted to see was in place, would it stop Rugby Australia sacking Israel Folau for saying what he said?
Well, that's a hypothetical, Tony, and one I can't answer because we haven't got the Religious Discrimination Act in place.
In a case like this, what would be the point of the law? That would be the key question.
Well, the key point would be that we would have a law which would set some parameters and some boundaries, and we don't have that at the moment. And that's why we need it. We have it when it comes to sexual discrimination. We have it when it comes to age discrimination. We have it when it comes to other forms of discrimination. But the boundaries are not clear at the moment when it comes to religion, and that's why I think we need a Religious Discrimination Act.
OK, where are they in your mind as the potential author of such a bill? Where are the boundaries in what Israel Folau said, that homosexuals and a variety of other sinners in his mind were going to hell?
Well,
so, I mean, he said that publicly. It's been construed as hate speech by some. How do you construe it?
Well, we've got to look at, finally, what the Parliament would say are those bounds. And my point is, at the moment, we don't have those boundaries in place, so we don't know.
But you'll be in government and you'll be making the decisions on what the legislation says, so what you'll be pushing for, at least, unless it's amended. So in this case, would it be OK for someone to say what he said?
Well, let's wait and see what the Parliament decides. Let's wait and see what the Cabinet decides the final makeup of a Religious Discrimination Act would look like. Let the Parliament set the boundaries, then let the courts test it, let the workplace relations laws test it, and then let's see as a society where we should draw the bounds. But at the moment, we don't have those bounds. And the United Nations clearly sets out that one of the fundamental rights is the right for religious freedom, yet we don't have that set in our laws here in Australia.
Okay,
and that
so,
is what
so
we
I'm
should
gonna,
be
I'm
doing.
Going to press you one more time. Yeah. Does your conscience tell you that he should have been able to say publicly what he said without recriminations?
Well, I haven't seen his contract that he has with
Rugby
Australia.
I'm talking about what he said.
Well, he has the right to say and to practice his religious beliefs, and that's what he's done. Now, I don't know what the contract was that he had with Rugby Australia, so I can't go into the rights and wrongs of that, and I think that'll play out in the courts. But he should have the right to practice his religious beliefs. That's been a fundamental that we've taken as a given in Australia. But what we're starting to see is that we haven't got clearly defined boundaries anymore when it comes to religious discrimination, like we do with sexual discrimination, like we have with age discrimination, like we have with disability, and that is why we need a Religious Discrimination Act in Australia.
OK, Sally Rugg, what do you think about a Religious Discrimination Act which could potentially make legal, completely legal, what Israel Folau said in his Instagram feed when he said homosexuals and a number of other sinners should or will go to hell because of the sins they're committing unless they repent?
Mm-hmm. So I do want to answer that question about a Religious Freedoms Act, but I just kind of want to pause for one second because I feel like we've been doing Q&A for what, like 4 minutes now, and already we've had like several people repeat the claims that someone like me is going to go to hell unless I repent, or there's something vague about me needing to be saved, and that was an act of kindness for someone to say that I would need to be saved. And I think it's really important, you know, we kind of bandy these words around and these ideas around as if it's some sort of philosophical argument, and as if these words don't mean things and they don't do things.
What do they do for you and other people from, let's say, the lesbian or the gay community?
Sure. I mean, I'm not going to repeat some of Folau's words, but he made a disgusting comment about transgender children. And that comment doesn't just exist in a vacuum. That comment exists in a reality where if you're a teenager in Australia who's transgender, you have a 1 in 2 chance of attempting suicide. 1 in 2. And the words that Folau uses about gay Australians, people like me, they exist in a context where the Morrison government is currently looking at whether people really care or not that religious schools can exclude LGBT teachers and students. So how do they make me feel? They make me feel a bit sick. They make me feel tired. I feel confused as to why in 2019 we're having this sort of like esoteric discussion about whether it is really harmful for these words to just sort of be bandied about in our society.
A national debate started by a rugby player.
That's
which
right.
Is quite unusual, I think.
Yeah. But in terms of a Religious Protections Act, I mean, protections are there to protect people. Protections are meant to be shields. And so I wouldn't want to see any sort of Religious Protection Act that takes away the protective shield that anti-discrimination laws have for people like me and the more vulnerable members of my community. Okay.